Welcome to Solarix. This is a sci-fi horror game that's supposed to have really open-ended levels with a bunch of different ways to approach any situation. I've heard it compared to things like System Shock 2 and Deus Ex. Now, whether those are actually good comparisons or not, I don't really know since I'm going into this almost entirely blind. But any sci-fi horror game that's even in the ballpark of System Shock 2 is something that I'm really interested in playing, so I'm excited to jump into this. It's made by Pulsetense Games, and you can grab it from at least a couple different places, including Steam. So I'll have links to that in the description. Alright, I've just played it for a couple minutes already just to make sure my settings are correct, so let's not resume game, let's start a new one. Let's go with medium. My turn for what?
Hello. I sincerely wish you well. If I were free of protocols and restrictions, I could fix this problem in half an hour. But instead, I require your assistance. Are you listening? Activate your flashlight.
Already done, but thank you.
Restore power to the surface colony's crew quarters.
Okay, so I guess that's AMI, Amy, Amai, however it's pronounced, which I guess is the artificial intelligence on this ship or base or whatever it is. She said surface colony's crew quarters, so I think we're on a planet, and it does look like we're in like some mountainous region. From what very little I can see outside. Yeah, it looks like a little colony here. Solarix company profile. Walter Terrace. Indefinite stasis. Male, 26. Engineering. Electrical engineer. Alright, so that must be me. I guess I just woke up from indefinite stasis. Why was I in stasis? And I guess I am a pretty good person to repair the electrical system since I am an electrical engineer. What do those say? I can't get up there. Someone got sick, and he'll think that it'll be worse. So there was an outbreak of something. Also, the audio mixing is a little bit wonky when it comes to voices. As you can see, they're pretty dang quiet compared to everything else. I checked the options menu. Unfortunately, there's really no way to turn it up. The voices are not on a separate volume slider. I'm pretty sure they're tied to the sound effects volume slider, which means that if I turn that up, then just like turning my flashlight on and off is going to become super loud along with the voices. But thankfully there's subtitles. It's flashing like I can use it, but I can't. I guess maybe I need the power restore to be able to use it or something. To you. He didn't die of a heart attack, that's for sure. Ah, cool. I'll throw boxes at the monster's faces. Wait a minute, why can't I pick it up again? It's weird. I can't pick this box up anymore. Nor that one. Bizarre. Get out of here. Alright, there we go. Before I go that way though, what's over here? An eerie light illuminating a pool of blood. So, is this what I need to repair to get the power back? Seems like it's some sort of electrical junction place.
You can't trust machines. All you can trust is whatever's in your head. And you can trust in me.
Who the hell is that? Betty? I don't think I want to trust her. She sounds kind of crazy. What is that? That sounds like something moving. Maybe it's not? Is it coming from this? Or down the hallway? That doesn't look safe. Flammable gas. Yeah, I think it's these terminals. It's a creepy noise. It sounds like servos or something, like some sort of robotic machinery moving. Yeah, we're nestled in here. On whatever we're on. Planet? Some asteroid of some sort, maybe? Who knows? Okay, what the hell was that? I think it saw me. Seems like it's coming for me, but it is outside and I'm inside, so I guess I'm safe for now. One of the infected, maybe? It looks like a door, and the thing was just right outside there. I hope it's not gonna come in that door. Oh god. Where the fuck is that coming from? Wait, is there no way back up? Can I not jump back up? You can't. Okay. I'm stuck down here. Great.
Remain vigilant. There are almost certainly anomalies in the area.
When you say anomalies, do you mean monsters? I think she means monsters. Can I make my own saves, by the way? No, so I guess it's only checkpoints, huh? There's so much machinery. Tons and tons of machinery. I don't know if this was some sort of a mining colony or something of the sort, or if this is machinery just to make the colony itself. I mean, obviously making a colony would require a pretty incredible amount of machinery and materials. I wonder if this was an attempt to leave Earth, perhaps? Start fresh somewhere else? Well, it's a bit too early for that speculation, I suppose. I don't really know anything about the story yet. All right, ghostly voices are not a good sign. Offline. Need the power restored for that, I suppose. I'm assuming the steam would hurt me. That ladder does not work. Oh god, I know there's gonna be a freaking monster soon. I'm tensing up just thinking about when it's gonna come. Oh, just a work light. Thought maybe that was somebody or something with a light, but no, just a work light. It's fine, it's fine. Ooh. This is a power generator? Oh, I need a power cell. Okay. I feel like I'm gonna be running back through here in just a minute. I'm gonna assume this steam doesn't hurt me. No, it doesn't. Alright, I'm gonna leave my light off. Oh. That's the one I saw from outside. It already came inside. Or it's another one that looks just the same, but I don't think so. I think it's the same one. This is a long hallway. To me, long hallways mean you're gonna have to run through them. I don't like long hallways. Oh god. There's the power cell, and I need to go back, and oh, yep. Yep, I'm gonna be running. I'm gonna be running. Power cell. big fat power cell enough to power an entire station. Jesus, there's that much energy stored in there? This must be far in the future, to have enough energy to power an entire station stored in something that I can hold in my hands. That's insane. Alright, I don't know where the monster's gonna come from, but it's gonna come. It's not? Really? I'm really surprised. I was expecting some lights to turn on or something, but no, it's just as dark as before. Damn it! Somebody needs to replace the light bulbs. I guess they've all burned out. Still using incandescents in the future.
I would suggest crouching when hostiles are in the vicinity. Crouching will allow you to move silently around the environment without being heard. If you walk or run, hostiles will hear your footsteps.
Thank you, Amy. Alright, now we need to make it back to the lift. Where was the lift? It's back a little bit further, right? Oh, alright, there it is. There it is. Alright, so I think the meter in the bottom left... Yeah, there's the red, which is obviously my health, and I think the little, like, light gem, or whatever you want to call it, is how much in the light I am. But yeah, it lights up when I'm there. Goes down when I'm in the dark. And obviously goes to max when I have my flashlight on. Yes, thank you, Tutorial Amy.
Oh, you poor thing! Stop whimpering and come out to play!
Wait, is that who the anomaly? Is that who the anomaly is? Is that Betty? Damn anomalies. Alright, I'm gonna wait for it to come back. And then as soon as it starts going the other way, I'm gonna come behind it. Alright, there's a lift. And it's right in the light. It's right there. Alright, here we go. Here we go. Whew. All right, we're good.
Hey, let me in. Police, they're everywhere. Let me in.
No. Creepy. Vacate the premises, alright? Tangerine prototype. Marvel of Solarix Enterprise Engineering. Looks to be some sort of augmented human? It's gotta be related to the anomalies.
Maybe I'm not sick.
Okay, oh my god, I can't even hear her. Is it ambient? Okay, so yeah, definitely some sort of infection was going on. Although, I only got like half of that because because the subtitles were out of sync with where the voice was, and almost impossible to hear. Even with ambient turned all the way down, I guess I'll just leave it a little bit lower than it was before. I don't know, the audio mixing's really, really bad. It's definitely very reminiscent of System Shock 2, though, finding audio logs everywhere. I like it. Although I'd like it more if I could actually hear what they were saying. Ooh. Electronic circuit bypasser. I thought for a second that was a taser. Oh my god, it's so adorable! It looks so much bigger. In fact, I think it was bigger when it was on there. It seems to have shrunk for some reason. But look at it, it's so cute! Also, my arm looks kinda weird. Am I one of those augmented tangerines? Tangerines, delicious. But yeah, unless that's just a weird glove, I think I might be augmented myself. Alright, judging by the bottom left infinity symbol, I'm guessing I can use this, well, infinitely long.
Firewalls and security measures built into the facilities. To use this device, stay close to the system in question and hold down the fire button. You will see the security on the door lessen until zero. Then press the interact key to open the door.
I wonder when I'm going to get more cyber modules. Come on, Shodan, give me some modules. Okay, that's pretty cool. Alright, so it takes a lot of time to hack through that. And that was only, what, 15% strength, and it took quite a while? And I noticed in the bottom left that my my light meter was kind of pulsing up and down as I did that, because it kept flashing. So I'm guessing you're going to have to be careful with when you do that. Maybe, like, bypass it a little bit, and then pull out when an enemy is kind of coming in your direction, and then wait again, and then start doing it again. Although, actually, it looks like the light meter is pulsing anyway, even though I'm not using it, which is kind of weird. I don't know why it'd be pulsing, because the lights aren't pulsing. Anyway, let's go. Yeah, she's the creepy one. But, alright, I wouldn't mind a chat. Oh, I think this is the other side of where I was before. Or maybe this is exactly where I was before. Ancira, the home of many mysteries and future of mankind. Uh-huh, sure. I don't think you want this to be the future of mankind. It is definitely the home of many mysteries, though. So I guess this is a planet, then.
places we're not supposed to go, and we're gonna mess with things we should have left alone. We'll tear it down, the two of us. I'm your only friend.
Please, no. I don't want to be your friend. Alright, how do I talk? Do I... useful to communicate when the helmet's built-in connection is off. Can I do something with it? Or is it just gonna happen, like, story-wise? Something's just gonna trigger. Is it an item I can select? No. Nope. Whoa. Okay, I didn't expect to actually be outside so soon. That rain is really pretty. This reminds me so much of Doom 3. And just any game that has, like, you know, sort of frontier on a spaceship or on a mining colony, future technology, lots of work lights set up everywhere as people are doing construction. Gregory Hart's forces. Who's Gregory Hart?
Sometimes we can't sneak past these guys, so we have to get a little crazy and creative, you know? See that mercenary on patrol? To distract him away from his patrol route, throw an object and he will go investigate it. Once his back is turned, you can sneak past him.
Okay, so I can shoot them, I can shoot out lights, I can throw objects to distract. Also, I've only got 9 shots in this thing, so I really do want to be careful. I don't know how many it'll take to put one of those things down, but I don't really intend to find out. Can I do, like, a melee attack with a weapon? I don't think so. I think it would have said. Oh, come on. Don't get stuck on the corner of the dirt clod. Also, I wonder how quiet this thing is. I mean, I can shoot out a light, sure, but aren't they going to hear me shooting? Then again, it is future technology, so maybe not. Said I need to throw a distraction to distract it to actually get past it, but do I really have to? It looks like there's enough time to just sneak behind it. Put the pillar in between me and it and then get into the darkness. I should be safe here. It looks pretty dark. Yeah, here we go. Oh, crap. Alright, those are things I can throw for distractions. Yeah, I don't really feel like I need them. I think I can just walk back there. I mean, I suppose we can try it, for the fun of it. There we go. Don't turn around, please. Oh god. Oh, it's kind of turning. Okay, we're good. Okay, oh, look at that. So it doesn't just search directly where the item is, it looks like it actually searches around the area. Smart. Smarter than most AI are. Can probably walk now, right? Oh, okay. Well, it was smarter than most AI is. However, I don't know if you can see what's happening in the distance. It seems to have gotten significantly less smart in the past minute. Oh, shit! Where did you come from? Son of a...
What? God damn it, I heard that!
I cannot guarantee unlimited radio communication. An external force has scrambled the connection. Do not engage Gregory Hart's soldiers. They know they're dying. They are delirious and volatile.
Yes, considerably.
Hmm?
Stand by. There's a disruption.
Okay, so just trying to keep this straight. There's a lot of things going on. So there's Amy, the ship's... Or I shouldn't say ship. We're not on a ship. The colony's, I guess, artificial intelligence. She wants me to help her, which is reminiscent of Shodan. There's an infection of some sort. There's, like, bionically enhanced soldiers. There's guards. I just talked to me. Whatever I is, it looks like it's... Seems like it's another artificial intelligence, perhaps? Maybe that's Xerxes. So I really don't know what's going on. But anyway, that was what I was distracted by. I wish I could zoom in. I don't know if you can see what's going on there. But that guard is most certainly walking into like a box.
I'm gonna die. Nobody can get used to the air around here. I'll never go back out.
Okay, I think he's actually just stuck in that light.
I can't stand this place.
Yeah. I take back everything.
Surprised the guns still work after all this time.
I take back everything I said about the AI being smart. Never mind.
They'll pay for what they did to us.
Well, there goes my immersion. But yeah, it sounds like what Amy said was correct, that they're delirious, and they know that they're going to die, because he was saying something about, I think, being sick or going to die. So maybe they have nothing to lose. I guess maybe they're the infected. I want to turn on my light, but I don't know if there might be more of the soldiers around. Alright, I think I'm good. Yeah, I think I'm good over here. Higher security. Is it a force field or just some sort of security scanner thing where if I go through it, it's going to trigger an alarm? Might be able to climb over. Ooh, look at the pretty light coming through it. Beautiful. Oh, I can just hack it. hope I get some sort of a stun weapon soon. I really want to stun them all. I want to play this game like Thief. Just blackjack them all in the back of the head. Can I get a space blackjack? Come on, turn around. There we go. Oh, you've even got, like, space buggies. We're stuck in, like, a freaking ravine, though, so I'm not exactly sure where you're gonna go with them. That guy sounded Russian.
I don't know if I still trust Mr. Hart. All of us are dying. I can't stand this place. Have to keep going. I'm just following orders.
Come on. Come on.
Another one of those monsters is sneaking around.
I want to hack that door, but I gotta wait.
One smart. We're doing the right thing. I hate this place. Same goddamn structures every day.
Alright, I think he goes back really, really fast, so let's wait for him to go back. He seems to stay over there for about a full minute. Oh wait, I don't even need to... Oh, I need an access card. Crap, okay. Alright, so they can't all be hacked.
I don't want to look. I just want to close my eyes forever. If we have to resort to cannibalism...
Wish there's something I could throw, but I can't. There's nothing here.
I don't know if I can get
there we go. These things are pretty cool looking. Go back there or over here. Let's go this way. I think that will lead back to where I was before, with the place that needed the keycard. Yeah, there's so many different ways to go. This is pretty open. It's like three distinct ways I can think of to go. I can go that way, I can go that way, and then I can go back there. I see some glowy stuff down here. Let's go this way. Maybe I don't want to go down here. Well, that's a dead person, isn't it?
You weren't supposed to see this. It's someone you know, isn't it? But you don't remember his face. You don't remember his face because I cut it out of your brain.
His hand might be useful for door scanning. Oh, Jesus, I need to cut off his hand? Alright, so I guess I need to find a saw? That is grim. Unless I'm just supposed to shoot his hand off. I could try that. There's nobody around, right? Alright, no. What the hell was that noise? I think this is the end of this place. It doesn't seem to go any deeper. Unless I can go up? Nah. Alright, I will come back there when I have a sharp implement. So that's that way down. Let's go this way. Seems safe. Oh, there's the bone saw. Yeah, there's no guards over here. Well, I know what I'm doing with that. 'Gilkin.' And she said that he was bit. So the disease, or whatever it is transmitted at least through biting. Alright, let's go back and get the hand. Cutting off a hand and using it to open a door reminds me a lot of Penumbra. Alright, there we go. No fanfare, no noise, just instantly separated. There we go. Engineer's hand. Might be useful to scan doors for access. Did my eyes deceive me, or is there a floating plant above my head?
You ain't listening to me. I cut it out. All of it. Every part that makes you docile. And I'll keep doing it whenever I please. You'll think they're all monsters. You'll never tell the difference.
I don't actually believe her, but then again, it wouldn't surprise me that much if I am also one of the infected. And everybody looks like monsters to me, but in reality, I'm the monster. Alright, where should I go now? I need a keycard to get to that door before, so I don't think the hand is going to do it. Let's go this way. Also needs a keycard. Alright, I think there's only one way I have not been. And that is basically around the other side of where I needed the keycard. So let's go back here and then just kind of cut straight through. Let's keep going forwards and then go to the right. Yeah, let's go this way. Oh, that's a second door, isn't it? It is. Alright, that's probably where I've got to go.
Yep. Peeling away.
Yeah, it's got a handprint.
Have to keep going. Gregory Hart gives me strength. I don't know if I can keep this up.
Alright, come on, come on, come on. How did he not hear that? Oh my god, what the fuck happened
Walter,
here?
Walter, you should have been here. They locked themselves in and they tore each other apart.
Holy crap. Where are the bodies? There's nothing but blood. They couldn't have survived after all this. Ooh, security guard.
Walter, I've recovered some radio contact. There was a signal in competition with mine, and I will need to investigate its nature. In the meantime, please proceed through the access tunnel and stand by for further instruction. Please trust me. Our actions will bring about a cure, eventually.
I wonder if perhaps Amy is actually trying to cure everyone here and actually trying to do the right thing, and maybe the other voices in my head are the voices of the infection or something? It's possible. Or perhaps the opposite is possible. Alright, so that's all that's here for me. What is this access card for? Because there's two places I can use it, right? Colony outskirts. Alright, so that's the place further away, not the place that's right next door. Alright, let's go. Wait, what? Objective incomplete? Search mercenary quarters. Gregory Hart's mercenaries must have the keys to the outskirts in one of these two buildings. One of the buildings can be accessed by hand signatures. Check. I need to search the other building in the surrounding area to find something to help. Okay, so I'm supposed to go here, but not yet. And this keycard won't allow me to get into the other place, so what am I missing? I'm not quite sure. Okay, well, I'll save that for the next episode. So, I think I'll end this one here before it becomes too long. My impression so far is that, it's a pretty interesting game. I really like that it's sci-fi horror and the whole setting and everything like that, and the fairly open-ended kind of level design. Very cool, I really like that. But at the same time, it really does feel kind of unfinished. The world feels kind of empty, the movement feels kind of janky, the AI is super, super janky. You saw what happened before with that one guard that just kept constantly running in for a couple minutes, just running into, like, a box. And then the other one, which got trapped behind a work light. Pretty janky. And it feels kind of unfinished in a lot of other ways, too, like cutting the hand off of the engineer on the ground, made no noise or anything like that whatsoever. It just feels kind of unfinished, and the audio mixing is all wonky. So it could definitely do with a lot more polish, but at the same time, I am still intrigued. I'm definitely intrigued. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.